medicine, so on. So moving further, see major approaches here as far as this high voltage laboratory is concerned, that measurement of peak values of AC, DC and both type of impulses is done by sphere gap. Okay, so sphere gap arrangement is a philosophy of measurement of peak voltages of AC. Okay, you know AC, say for example, it's a sinusoidal signal, right? And this sinusoidal signal has got a peak value. So peak value, and that peak value is responsible for breakdown of its breakdown of any insulation depends on the peak value. A sphere gap arrangement is the best approach to measure the peak value of AC signal. Now DC voltage itself is a peak value. The sphere gap arrangement can also be used for measurement of large value of DC voltage, and both type of impulses means a lightning impulse as well as this switching impulse, their peak value. You know, this impulse is a rising signal. It has front time, okay, and then it has fall time, right? So it has a tail type of signal. So sphere gap arrangement is one of the approach used. Then see second. In previous slide, I just listed out the different philosophies. Here we are trying to see how different approaches are there. For example, effective value, you know, effective value is an RMS value, right? This guy waiting. Okay, effective value or RMS value of AC or DC is measured by electrostatic voltmeter, right? So that is what I said. In measurement of AC or DC voltage and impulse is done by dividing system. Of course, some kind of dividers, rheostats, or capacitors, capacitor divider, resistance divider, these kind of philosophies are used. You know, the if you want to measure large voltage, what you do is you introduce small shunt there and you measure the voltage across that, and then you do some calculations. The similar philosophy is used here. Measurement of AC voltage by peak voltmeters. Okay, so a peak voltmeter is a kind of measuring philosophy where the peak value of AC is measured. And now recently, after the development in the field of electronics and optical measurements, now this optical measurement has become very typical, right? Yeah, and recently you have been observing that on the airport, there is a laser beam which is put on the head to check the temperature. So that is how the optical measurements, contactless systems are used for the measurement of high voltage. So this is going to be the content of our unit number 5. And it is clear that what are the different kind of philosophies you will be coming across in this chapter. Now, this is the first, okay? A peak voltage measurement using a standard sphere gap. So standard sphere gap is going to be used. And you can see here, this particular sphere gap arrangement, where I'll just try to explain this slide, that how this sphere gap arrangement, before this is possible, let me take you quickly to this slide where you can see the picture, right? You can see the huge spheres are there, right? There are two spheres, there's a gap here, and you can notice here there is an upper sphere and there is a here at the bottom, and somewhere here you can notice that there is a some kind of support, and there is some kind of mechanism also with a motor, so that the distance of the sphere gap vertically can be adjusted. You can see this is insulating support. This is also an insulating support, but this pier is made from aluminium or copper or some kind of brass material is there. And one particular sphere is a fixed one and other sphere is a movable. That means this air gap is adjustable. Even another picture, this is a horizontal, this is a vertical arrangement where you can see that this particular arrangement looks like a vertical sphere arrangement. And here you can see the two spheres are having gap, right? One sphere is a fixed one, and other sphere can move horizontally in either direction. So that the distance between the two spheres or the gap can be, yes, horizontal sphere gap of 250 mm, right? So the diameter of this sphere gap is also important. And we have to understand now that how this kind of arrangement, which is shown, can help us measure the high voltage. And remember, there are three types of all these three signals can be measured by sphere gap arrangement. And which are the three signals? For example, it's AC signal, its peak value can be measured. Remember, I'm saying AC means I'm talking about its peak value, not the RMS value. Okay. And DC, and then third one is its impulse. Again, when I say impulse, means I'm talking about what's the problem with Prashad? The Sedki is coming in and coming going out. Just check it with your internet connection. So when I say impulse, then I'm talking about the peak value. Okay. So therefore the title is a measurement of peak value, right? So going back to the previous slides. Okay, this is a concern slide. This slide contains some diagrams and some text material. Okay, here the labels are there, several labels are there. A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever. And the definitions of these labels are given here. This is a vertical sphere gap arrangement. I was just showing you the picture. And this is a horizontal sphere gap arrangement. And both have their advantages, disadvantages, and cost, and size, and portability, and all those things. But the philosophy of measurement remains same, right? So here, this is for 100 cm sphere gap radius. So this this is the specification, 100 centimeter sphere gap radius. When I say the radius, so the sphere gap radius I'm referring. Okay. So now, see, you have one P. P is a one particular. Here the sparking gap is there basically. And spacing is there as per this definition. The spacing is there. And here the spheres are mounted. And then here the upper sphere is connected to the ceiling. This is the ceiling roof of the laboratory. And this number one, that is some kind of insulating support. So this sphere is supported. I just showed you the picture also. And then we have got a sphere shank. So there is a shank here. It is just to connect, it's a metal part. It is connected to the sphere. It holds the sphere. And then the number two, which is a shank, is a more metal body, is rigidly fixed to this number one. And you can see here some kind of circular ring at phi. Okay, that is for stress distribution. You remember the toroidal ring or so, because every contact point has a sharp edges. And then we need to control the stress also. So here, for stress control, some kind of toroidal ring is placed here. And this number four indicates the voltage connection. Here, the high voltage which is to be measured will come from that side. So somewhere here, there is a high voltage which is to be measured. So one wire will come to this upper sphere. Through this number four is a resistance, or current limiting resistance, because once the spark gap operates, then this current will be high and that has to be limited. Otherwise, this current will create a problem to the surface of the sphere gap the surface will get there will be a spitting or some kind of pitting or something would be there, and there's some micro damages may take place over the surface during every measurement, and again there are sharp edges form, and that creates a problem for the measurement, or that introduces a measurement error. And so here you can see number 3 is operating gear. Okay, that means some kind of gear or some motor is there. This motor will push the spear upward and downward, right? And that is how you can adjust the spacing S between these two. So other things are there, other dimensions are there. All these dimensions are for a particular type of, I mean, for this particular type of spear gap arrangement of 100 centimeter spear gap radius. And you can see this letter B. B, what B indicates, radius of the clearance. So there should be some clearance, horizontal clearance from the center, because the other structure, this wall should be far away. This wall should not be close. Otherwise, there will be a breakdown between wall and this the spear gap, because there is a very high voltage. Okay, so I hope you understand here what are the important here. Just what is important is one upper spear is a fixed one, and the lower spear is a movable. You can push this lower spear upward and downward, so that you can change the spacing, right? And few things are there. You can notice that so two adjacent metal spears. Okay, this is what I told you. Basic mechanism of high voltage measurement is by spear gap. Breakdown voltage of air gap in uniform is determined by the distance. So this distance versus voltage, a table is prepared. We'll see what is that table. And that table is a lookup table is already available. The manufacturer has provided you lookup table. So when you adjust the gap and when the sparking takes place, because if the gap is too large, you have applied some voltage here, say for example, you have applied some voltage, and then this voltage has to be measured. So if the spare gap distance is too large, then the sparking will not take place. So what you have to do is, you have to gradually push this spear upward slowly, and you have to stop as soon as sparking takes place. Is that clear to you? See, what you are doing here is, you have one spear at the top, and you are pushing the spear at the bottom upward. So at a certain spacing, there will be a breakdown of the air, because you know what happens. All Townsend's theory and everything will come in picture for a specific space. So as soon as the sparking occurs, so your motor will stop. So you have to measure that distance. And again, you are not going to go there and measure it. Some kind of system will display the distance. Okay. And then you have to look up this calibration. Say for example, see if this XYZ is a distance, then there is some voltage. For example, let me take you. This is what I told you. Now please look at this. This is a typical table I have taken from one paper article. This is not there in the book. And this author has, researcher has calibrated a spear gap. How it is calibrated? See, for example, you know the peak voltage. Some voltage is known to you, and that voltage is applied. So once that voltage is applied, then you adjust the spacing, right? And as you adjust the spacing, a breakdown occurs, okay? And that breakdown, you mark that breakdown as a standard value. For example, you know this value, and at this distance, the breakdown has occurred. So you give the same this one, and then you have to plot a. See, you need a two points. You have set certain one mm distance, 1 centimeter distance, and there is a sparking taking place, and you know the value in advance because that's low voltage, for example. And then you have another point. Say, for example, here you have increased the distance to 2, and then sparking again occurs. You are increasing the voltage, of course. So that voltage is known to you is a 59.38. So you get a second point, right? And then you plot. Then you can extrapolate. For plotting a straight line, you need a two points. So assuming that the breakdown is a linear, because see, the humidity is important, temperature is important, pressure is important. Other variables are also there. They are going to create a problem. So if you have two points on the graph, you can draw a straight line, and then other points you can directly write here. I think I don't know whether you are getting me or not. I think we have 5 minutes left, and Ajit, are you there, Ajit?
Yes, sir.
What did I say actually? Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Just tell me what you want to. For example, yes, you look at this. What did you understand here?
So there are two different arrangements, horizontal and vertical.
That's fine. That's fine. Measurement philosophy. Could you understand measurement philosophy?
No, sir. Not that much.
First point. How to? Okay. I have second. Rishikesh is there. Rishikesh, just go ahead. Tell me what is the measurement philosophy you understood here.
Yes, sir. First, we apply the voltages to the spare, okay. And the lower spare is a mobile to move.
Right.
Then we change the distance accordingly, and when the spark occurs,
Check your microphone. Your microphone. Take your micro. Your microphone is not close to your mouth.
Hello.
Yes. Now tell me. Yes. Is it, yes. Comfortable. Yes, go sir. Ahead.
Yes, sir. When we apply the voltage to the spare,
okay.
Then the lower spare is actually a mobile one.
Okay.
And after moving that spare upwards, when the breakdown occurs, then that particular voltage is actually a breakdown voltage. By that way we can measure that particular breakdown voltage.
Okay, so I mean, what I'm trying to tell you people is that you said rightly that upper spare is a fixed one, voltage is applied to the upper spare, and now you take the lower spare upward, which is mobile. Okay, so for this given voltage, for a given voltage there will be some breakdown, right? Now first, initially you have to separate how you will calibrate. So for that purpose, I was trying to convince you. If you look at this table, I have first adjusted a spare gap to 1 centimeter distance, and then there is a spare gap breakdown for a particular voltage. That voltage was also adjusted. And for this combination, that means 1 centimeter is the spare gap distance, and for this voltage, which is known to us, there was a sparking. So we decided, we have written now 1 centimeter is equal to 31.02 kV. We are calibrated. 1 centimeter corresponds to 31.02. Then we took another point. So we set the distance to 3 centimeter. And we changed the voltage. We gradually increased the voltage, and we noticed that at 83.24 there is a sparking. So this 3 centimeter corresponds to 83.24, right? So I think there are Miss Shruti is there. Is Shruti? Oh, Shruti is surrounded by all family members. say other Shruti Patil is there. Shruti Patil? Hello? Shruti Patil? Okay, keeping silent. Mandar, could you understand Mandar? Mandar is there? Okay. See, you people should not unmute. I have all control from your side. Okay, next lecture, during next session, you should not unmute. I can control your mics from my end. And I think Amruta Shinde, could you understand this?
No, sir.
See, I was trying to tell you that. Hello? Yes. Didn't you understand anything out of this?
Not that much, sir.
Oh, you should understand because it's less than 1 minute left now. So what